FDNY firefighters were placed on leave after refusing to comply with the vaccine mandate. 6. New York City Fire Department, NYFD, firefighters were suspended for 4 weeks without pay on Friday. Following an incident involving on-duty firefighters and an elected official's staff, according to a statement from a NYFD spokesperson. According to a representative for New York State Senator Zellner Myrie's office, the firefighters drove a fire engine to the senator's Brooklyn office in protest of the city's COVID-19 vaccination mandate. According to Mayor Bill de Blasio's order, members of the NYFD, the NYPD, and other municipal employees must provide documentation of at least one vaccine shot by 5 p.m. Friday or face unpaid leave. Myrie's spokesman, Matt Baer, said the firefighters went to the senator's office, rang the doorbell, and sought to speak with him about the vaccine mandate in a cordial discussion, according to Baer. The firefighters asked Baer, who was in the office at the time, where the senator lived, and then claimed that the city will have blood on its hands by Monday due to the vaccine mandate. Myrie has not been personally involved with the citywide vaccine mandate, according to Baer. We adore firefighters, and we don't have any issues with them, he stated. The firemen's actions were questioned by FDNY Commissioner Daniel A. Negro. This is a highly irresponsible act by on-duty members of this department who should be focused only with responding to crises and assisting New Yorkers, not harassing an elected official and his staff, Negro said in a statement released on Friday. The members in question have been dismissed from duty and will face disciplinary action, says the statement. The firefighters were from the FDNY's Brooklyn-based Ladder 113. According to a source familiar with the situation, the FDNY planned a 20% reduction in service beginning Monday. Members of the FDNY who opposed the mandate rallied outside Gracie Mansion, the mayor's official residence, on Thursday, holding signs that read, "Essential workers aren't disposable heroes, sick. My body my choice, and hashtag natural immunity." The mandate has been bashed by fire and police unions, with Uniformed Fire Officers Association President Jim McCarthy calling the requirement that firefighters make a decision on the vaccine by Friday unconscionable. Vaccination rates for the FDNY, NYC Department of Sanitation, and NYC Department of Corrections increased by 3% from Saturday to Sunday night, according to de Blasio's office. According to the data, the percentage of FDNY employees who have received at least one dose of the COVID-19 vaccine has increased from 78% on Saturday to 80% today. And, as of Sunday night, there were still 22,800 unvaccinated employees in New York City. On Tuesday, October 19, the day before de Blasio's office announced the vaccine mandate, the city reported 46,300 unvaccinated public employees. According to data provided by the mayor's office throughout the weekend, at least 1,400 NYC employees received at least one dosage of the COVID-19 shot from Saturday night to Sunday night.